हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम इन द सीरीज ऑफ द वीडियो लेक्चर ग्रिड एंड द क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द व्हाट इज ग्रिड एंड द ग्रिड कंप्यूटिंग। इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द विच टॉपिक्स एंड द कंटेंट्स इंक्लूडेड अंडर दिस वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज मीन बाय ग्रिड एंड द ग्रिड कंप्यूटिंग। सो लेट्स फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज मीन बाय द ग्रिड। So let's first try to understand what is mean by the grid. Grid is nothing but the network of a computer. In given diagram, nodes or the computer, or this is also called workstation, nodes, computer or PCs are connected through this communication network. Now this communication network are kind of LAN, MAN or the WAN. It may be homogeneous or the heterogeneous. When this node are connected under the same area network called as homogeneous. If this node are under the different kind of communication network like LAN, MAN, called as a heterogeneous network. So in these nodes or this computer are distributed all over a geographical area and connected through this communication network. So the main purpose of the grid is performing or build a infrastructure so each node can coordinate and enable the resource sharing. Means what? Here, the grid refer as an infrastructure that enable coordinate resource sharing and problem solving in dynamic under the virtual organization. That means the main purpose of the grid is make as an infrastructure. So each node can coordinate and this enable a resource sharing under the virtual organization to solving a problem. Means what? The grid is used for the solving a particular problem in dynamic or the under virtual organization. So that is all about the grid. Next, in the grid, computer grids allows access to the computing resources. Now what are the resources that grid is going to allow? Resources like maybe RAM, processor, some sensor or data server, graphic card, storage, etc. So all these resources can be allowed. So grid allows access to this all the resources from many different locations, just as a world wide web allows access to the information. For example, if this particular computer have some complex problem and this complex problem can be solved this particular computer, or maybe it cannot be solved. So it depends upon the resources which the computer needed to solve the particular complex task. Now the resources are like now just we discuss the resources like processor, storage, RAM, etc. If this computer have the all resources, then it can be solved by this single computer very easily. But if the problem is very complex, then the complex problem cannot be solved by this single computer. So we need the various resources to solve this complex problem. So by using this grid concept, then this computer is going to solve complex problem. So that is all about the grid. Now we'll see what is mean by the grid computing. In the grid computing, we'll first see what is the definition. That in the definition, grid computing can be defined as a network of computers working together to perform a task that will rather be difficult to single machine. All machines on the network work under a same protocol to act like a virtual supercomputer. That means what? First of all, we see what is meant by the computing. Computing is nothing but to compute, or computing that means compute any problem or solve any complex problem, we can say. So as previously discussed, one single computer cannot be solve a complex problem. So to solving that complex problem, we need a supercomputer. Now, what is mean by the supercomputer? Supercomputer, that means the computer which holds the huge amount of memory or the processor or the large number of processor are available to solve a complex problem, because supercomputer solves any complex problem. But instead of the supercomputer, here we are using the concept called as a grid computing. Now if the this particular node or this particular computer have the limited resources, Then the computer task or that computer complex problem is divided across the within this grid. So in the given diagram, the complex problem, this is the complex problem, and it divides into the into different grids or different nodes within this grid, which is present this under the network communication. Now here the problems like the same or common problems is divided into P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6 within this node under this grid. And the solution of that problem is gathered at one computer, and that computer is nothing but a server or the control node, and that server gives the solution of that complex problem. So that is nothing but the grid computing. So instead of solving a problem by the supercomputer, the network of the computers working together to perform a task, and that will rather be difficult for the single machine. So that is the grid computing. There is one more another definition of grid computing. So let's see that. Grid computing is defined as the ability to form virtual collaborative organization that share the application and data in the open heterogeneous server in order to work common problem. That means what? These nodes are under the grid called as a grid client. So these grid clients are working under one common problem and act under the virtual resources, and this grid client connected through this communication network. So this is the grid computing. So we see the architecture of the grid computing. This is the architecture of the grid computing. In the architecture of the grid computing, there are three parts. First part is the user, U1, U2, U3. Second is the grid server and the admin. And third is the grid client. This is the grid client. And this grid client connected to this communication network. These are the three parts. Now, for example, user U1, this is user U1, gives the task to the grid server. Now, the grid server divide this task across this grid and divided that task within these nodes. Now, these nodes can perform the task independently and return the result to the grid server, and grid server merge that result and returns back to the user one. So the grid server is returning the result to the particular user. So under this grid architecture, there are three parts: user, grid server, and the client, grid client. So the grid client, in this grid client, one software are uses, because the grid client are working under the virtual organization. For that purpose, there are some software or protocol are installed, and that software is nothing but the middleware. So under the grid architecture, we are using the middleware or the grid network software, that is the middleware, means user, grid server, grid client, and the middleware. So this is all about the grid computing architecture. In under this architecture, the middleware work as a here the software that binds the all these resources together is called a middleware. Middleware is nothing but the software. In this client, this is the client. The client uses this software called as a middleware. Now, the grid client uses the installed software or the protocol to act under the virtual organization. So there are many different types of middleware developed for the many different types of grid. Now, depending on the grid types, the software or the middleware developed, because the different protocols of the different types of the grids, like data grid, utility grid, and departmental grid, we will see that all types of grid in upcoming video lecture. So depending on the grid, the software is also going to vary. So middleware does all the work to connect users, jobs to computing resources, thereby hiding the grid's complexity from the user. So middleware hiding the all complexity from the user. In the architecture of the grid computing, the grid computing server or the personal computer runs independent tasks and link by the internet. So in this distributed architecture, a large number of computer or the server connected and uses a common resource pool, and this common resource pool has a huge storage, processor, etc. So computer workstation, these are the computers, and that computers are works independently, and this computer act like a supercomputer because they share the resources from the common resource pool. So in the grid computing, server or the personal computers run independent tasks and link by internet. It is distributed architecture of large number of computer connected to solve a complex problem. Now next, in the grid architecture, as we discussed now, the grid computing is a way of connecting computing resources to share their computing power. These computing resources include data store capacity, some computing power, processor, sensor, virtualization tools, etc. So next, in the computing architecture, here in the given diagram, one person work on one single this computer which is connected across this grid, and this computer is solve a complex problem. So this computer solve the complex problem, and this computer now act as a supercomputer because this computer shares many resources from this different grid under the geographical area. So it is act under a virtual organization to make a fast progress in their work. So here the grid computing is a way of connecting computing resources to share their computing power. Using a grid, someone sitting at one computer and combine capabilities of the hundred and the thousands of the computer, providing researchers with the extra power to make faster progress in their work. So this is all about the grid computing and how it is. Now we see why grid computing becomes popular because ability to make use of unused computing power, and thus it reduce the cost effectively. Then second, it enable heterogeneous resources of computer to work cooperatively and collaboratively to solve a complex problem, and the complex problem with the HPC based application. Now HPC is nothing but the high performance computing, this grid computing belong to this HPC. The high performance give the high performance of the speed and performance and throughput. So what is mean by high performance grid computing? We are going to study briefly in the next video lecture of HPC, but the grid computing belonging to the HPC application. So these are the reason why the grid computing becomes a very popular. Next we'll see what are the characteristics of the grid computing. The characteristics are like, grid computing can be independent to each other in terms of the location. Then there is large scale, it deals with the large computing resources. Then geographical distribution, computing resources located at the different place. Unlimited resources adding scaling, adding resources in the existing system. And resource coordination. So these are all the characteristics of the grid computing. Then we'll see what are the applications of the grid computing. So grid computing have these applications. Mainly the grid computing work under the research area like industrial research, biomedical research, engineering research, chemistry, medical, and Grid Republic organization. Grid Republic organization, this is the Republic organization, is a real example of the grid computing and working under the concept of the grid computing. बेसिकली ग्रिड कंप्यूटिंग अप्लाइड अंडर द लाइक रिसर्च एरिया रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट और द यूनिवर्सिटी वर्क विच कैन बी डन वर्क अंडर द कॉमन एरिया और रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूशन प्रोवाइड अ सर्विस थ्रू द कॉमन इंटरफेस एंड अंडर द वर्चुअल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर और इट कैन बी अप्लाइड मोस्टली इन द रिसर्च ऑफ कॉमन कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रॉब्लम कैन बी सॉल्व एंड अंडर द सेम एरिया एंड इन द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द एप्लीकेशन इफ यू आर मोर इंटरेस्टिंग इन द ग्रिड कंप्यूटिंग गो थ्रू दिस लिंक ग्रिड रिपब्लिक ऑर्गनाइजेशन इट इज़ वेरी गुड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ द ग्रिड कंप्यूटिंग एंड आई ऑल्सो गिवन द लिंक इन डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ द ग्रिड कंप्यूटिंग नाउ वील सी द वॉट आर द एडवांटेजेस Now we'll see the advantages of the grid computing. It is not centralized as there are no servers required except the controls node which is just used for the controlling and not for the processing. As we discuss in the architecture of the grid computing, there are no servers. There are control node that means there are a grid server which is just used for the controlling and it is not used for the processing. And second advantage, multiple heterogeneous machines, that means the machines with a different operating system can be use a single grid computing network. Then next, tasks can be performed parallel across various physical location. Because of this, the HPC is working or HPC is the apply. HPC is nothing but the high performance computing. So this is the advantage of the grid computing. There are some disadvantage of the grid computing. That we'll going to see the what are the disadvantage. In the disadvantage of the grid computing, technical challenges like how to distribute resources and fix problem, allocate the job to that to the grids under the that nodes and coordinate between the different middleware used by the grid client. Now the there are different kind of grids are there so. Depending on the grid, the middleware is also differentiate between this grid client because different types of grid use the different kind of software. So coordination between the different software or the different middleware used by the grid client it makes a difficult. Second disadvantage is the who should be allowed it to use the each grid. Who should be? That means the which computer or which workstation is allowed to use the each grid. And who job should get the priority in the queue to use the grid. So this is the disadvantage. And this is some technical challenges also which are overcoming in the cloud computing concept. That concept we'll going to see in upcoming video lecture. So this is all about the disadvantage. And one more important point regarding the grid computing is basically grid computing is very good for the resource utilization. That means computer resources utilized very efficiently, then resource can be shared and grid computing is act like a supercomputer. So this is all about the grid computing and I hope you understood this video, what is grid computing. What is the architecture, then how it is work, what are the characteristics, then what are the disadvantage, advantages of the grid computing and what are the application. So in the next video lecture, we'll see going to see the what is mean by the HPC or the high performance computing. So till then, like this video, subscribe the channel and don't forget to press the bell button so you get the all updates. Thank you.